For this song, we had written probably 7 or 8 songs for the stage, and we knew we needed something kind of with one foot in the older stuff and had more of a groove, and then we wanted to do something that, you know, also kept with the concept of the stage. So we had basically 3 different songs that we were working on that we kind of blended together and seemed cool. You know, the intro, and then the beef of the song, and then also the bridge.
Shall we get into it? Check it out.
Yeah, well, so the first part of the song was you called me and you're like, I want the record to open with like the opening of a movie with some cool chords that are bending, and it was actually harder to pull off than we thought it was gonna be. Like, there's no button you push to make everything bend perfectly. So we were in there with Jason Fries, and you know, as we were looking through this, what was interesting was that how many individual tracks it took to make this. If you were to play it by itself. Yeah, but as you start taking stuff out, and that kind of adds like the buzzsaw bite, right. You know. And these were kind of more the
sort of traditional the depth. Lo-fi, yeah.
And then you had the bass drop. Well, I don't remember the little flourish at the end. So then in the studio, we really pushed Brooks on this drum intro. We wanted him to feel like it was like a machine and it was building from the ground up. So here's the drum tracks. Just by themselves, no samples. Like I said, one take. Once he nailed it, he nailed it. Okay, so I remember this part. He'd finally come back and he had it all done and he switched his kick drum pattern halfway through, and I said, you know, I think it's really gonna bug me if all the bottom end falls out, because that rhythm of and the look he gave me on his face was like, you want me to continue that part over this new rhythm I'm doing on the toms? And it was just like, you know, a million things going on at once, and you know, he nailed it. So is there anything you want to say about the guitar part?
Yeah, I think the guitar riff is pretty cool, especially what it supports harmonically for the vocal. So, so it's E minor to kind of an E flat major sort of chord, but it's used in 2 different ways. For the 5, now here's the E flat. So now you're hitting E flat major there. So it's 2 different ways to sing over that thing. So more bang for your
buck. Interesting thing about when we did this vocal melody, this was kind of like what's off the top of our heads right there. It didn't take very long, and it was one that we were trying not to overthink. And I remember we just started going, like it was like aggressive, go, 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 and everyone's like, yep, done.
Yeah.
And that was kind of cool because it was quick and easy and it was off the cuff.
Yeah. Ironically, like you said, we weren't thinking about it at the time, but it literally goes from traditional how we would sing to this postmodern sort of thing. Like back and forth, but to me pretty seamlessly.
Oh, real quick, can you bring up these talking vocals? I spent probably 6 hours in the studio with Joe doing these over and over and over. And you know, on the demo, they were kind of nailed and they were easy. And then when you're doing it for real, I remember getting so frustrated at Joe because he kept going, it's not believable. I don't like it. Doesn't sound good. Nope. Nope. So this one.
It seems these sheep have quite an appetite. Who is the crap?
I think we added a doubler to it.
Yeah.
Well, it seems these sheep have
that one has a doubler.
Quite an appetite.
A little bit of one. And then 2 organic ones, and they just like blend to the flangey sort of thing.
And then let's talk about the chorus a little bit. Let's see what we got here. Well, first off, we do a pre-chorus.
Yeah, it's like we sit on the 5, so it's kind of the same key, but it starts developing its own tonality.
Makes you feel something.
Yeah.
You're like, oh, okay, something's going on there, and then it basically set us up for what the chorus would be, which is kind of a drop into the chorus. Because originally the chorus was written on piano, and it's really hard to do the chords justice when you have all this distortion on it. And so one thing that you were doing was... accentuate the chords.
Right.
Such a better feeling. on top of that, we had the duels. And this was another thing of kind of being cognizant of one foot back in the past of Avenged Records while also moving forward. So we had the duels and the chorus. And then this gets us to the bridge, which really could have been its own song. The initial part of the bridge was one microphone, and then it switches halfway through. So see if we can hear that right now.
And the wind speaks a gospel.
So for this part, we want something smoother. And then with right. The raspy voice, we want something more bite to it.
And the wind speaks a comforting voice, guiding me to her arms. Mother, I'm all right. It took the birth to send the snake, rattle the
mud
before a blow to the head, by the gavel of time to wake up.
And like, what I like about this is, you pull a lot of tracks apart, you're gonna hear the auto tune, you're gonna hear all these things, but you can hear every single little wavery thing in my voice because nothing was touched.
Hills don't abandon me now, seeing that I'm out here alone, I'm running out of fight.
All the vibrato, nothing's taken out,
yeah.
Which is cool. Couple different tones.
It's cool, it's labeled. So we got the Lux. Lux through the Helwyn. What's the Audio Kitchen? So the Clean's a blend of this amp, great amp called Audio Kitchen, as well as the Helwyn. What the hell is the Deluxe?
This is my favorite part here. And Get Dark.
Right.
It's such a cool shift.
Yeah.
Again, the heavy notes are going to come in and it's going to take away from the just the feeling.
Yeah.
So you got to keep these chords going to kind of accentuate. It's like a different song.
Best ballad we ever wrote.
Well, if you can't play a song on acoustic guitar and sing it, it's not a good song.
It's not. There it is. Play that in acoustic.
There, and then
we could.
The songs are in. Before the effects. Yeah. Just a laugh. I remember this part gave us trouble. It's like the ending of the second song we're into, and it's like, how the fuck do we get back to the chorus? And that was a problem for a long time, and then we just said, let's just dive right back in. Like, your ear's gonna shift, everything's gonna shift. And we, you know, just went over the top of it. You know, people don't notice the atrocious transition there.
Scream.
Scream. Don't ever know. So we got here.
You do know this is just a simulation. Don't you? Who is the crab?
Here we go. Making beautiful music here. And then basically we're out on the last chorus, and then to me, even the middle and the chords, they could be very, almost like, Western's not the right word, but
they're Spanish, they're actually Spanish. Super
okay.
Spanish, yeah.
So very Spanish, and then we wanted to kind of accentuate that. And so at the end, we really drove it home with the two guitars. So here's the very beginning, the music will be playing over it. I mean, this was interesting to me because just hearing you do this in the studio, there was so much clicking and popping, and I just wasn't used to hearing stuff like that, but it's really what makes it authentic.
Totally.
It's nylon string, though, right?
Snappy and crackly.
And this is the part where you'd hear it on the record more.
Yeah. Looked like some of those cleans were done with a blend of my guitar, 54 Strat, and the Nash Tele for some of those really rich traditional clean sounds, which is just so fucking bizarre. the Hellwinds in there, you know, and we worked really hard to make sure that that had some cool, clean tones. And I just feel like it's super unique. It's super organic, but modern and just kind of weird.
Which is cool. It makes it real. It's just, you know, a record about artificial intelligence, but, you know, we're still human. You know, we're making a human record, and this is a human song. So, pretty cool. Not a lot of trickery going on here. It's just pretty simple, really.
It's a lot of organic, a hell of a lot of organic.
Yep. Well, good enough for a nomination, not good enough for a win.
Yep.
Good enough for a Grammy nomination, but not quite good enough for a win.